There you go, that was the 18th graduation ceremony of YMCA, and hope to see you next year for the 19th ceremony, YMCA. Now, a few days ago, Mackay University striked, and today I'm hanging out with some of my friends at house party. They're going to tell me reasons why Mackay University is striking again this year. Gentlemen, how are you doing?
I'm good. How are you doing?
What is your name?
I'm Nwaga Darius, a social scientist, and in my third year.
So why is Mackay University striking again?
We are doing the 60% policy. The one they imposed on us, and this is a policy that has been conquering on our parents and us as students, and we are trying to make sure that so that they eliminate it, because we are not all from good
let
financial
me tell you something. Background. Almost every year Mackay University strikes about a 60% tuition. You mean for the past year things are not working out?
The problem is the administration. If they check this, why don't they remove the policy? Because for us, we are willing to concur with this. They should remove the policy, because we have been fighting all this time. So let them sit down and erase this policy.
Okay. Apart from that, let me talk to more people right here. How you doing?
I'm good.
What is your name?
I'm Elias. I'm doing law. I'm in year two.
Year two. Now, apart from the 60% tuition, is there any other reason why Mackay University is striking?
Yeah, there's another reason, and that reason I think is rep.
Oh, okay. Rep. Who was rep?
There was a situation at campus whereby students were saying that lecturers are raping them. But I think...
I heard about that. A student was raped by a lecturer, right? Yeah. Where did it happen?
I don't really recall, because I've been busy with work and stuff. But I think that stuff happens when lecturers, they give money to students.
But no, I don't think this was the student given money.
No. I don't think it was, such a scenario, because once maybe a student gives in, her body or man, I don't regard that as rape. Maybe I think rape, maybe she was forcefully put into act. And I think that's what happened.
What do you have to say about that situation?
That situation was like the lecturer wanted to raise the GPA of the student. But yeah, it was like a second year student. Yeah, and she was like she wanted to speak with the lecturer. In that contest, the lecturer wanted wanted something back in return.
Yeah. But I'm wondering, where did it happen? Because if it happened, of course, if you are wanting something from a lecturer, you must find them in office, not in their homes. Where did it happen?
It happened like the lecturer stays is near the hostel of that girl. Remember that, because remember that girl, they have just started their exams. I think she's a first year student, by the way. And the reason why we are striking, we guys put ourselves in the fit whereby you go and find a girl, you speak to her, you insert their money. But on the side of the lecturer, he is having money, he's having everything, he's having every good.
But then to me, I also blame the girl. You need to agree with me, guys, because if you have anything that you want to settle with the lecturer, you must meet them in office, not at their homes.
I think the girl should say no and should focus on their future. Read hard, read their books, They make it in life,
And I believe if you fail, you can as well take a retake. Simple, right?
I think to add more light on that issue, I think students or campuses should focus more on what brought them at campus. You understand? Sometimes, you want the life, you focus less on your books, and that is really, really not good at all. So we need to focus more, focus on your studies. I think we shall minimize such risks. And then I think also lecturers should look at their job description that much.
Okay, thank you so much, guys. Yes, we still hang out here at the house party. Just behind me, I have the view of the beach. Yes, indeed, it's a beach house, actually. Now, let's go check out your outstanding personality. And of course, I'll be back with more vibes coming up around your campuses.
I'm at the top of the game, so you can call me the leader. In Jesus Christ, but I'll be your savior. Healing the sea creepers, so call me the doctor. Scared to attack the Ugandan fear factor. I'm called Rele Enoch, aka Fab E, from Makerere University. I am doing Bachelor of Arts in Economics, third year, and I'm honored to be your outstanding personality today. Handling school and doing music is something really hard. In case you have passion for something, you gotta go for it. You can't wait for school to end. Learning never ends, so you can't first say, let me stop school, then do music. No, you gotta go for what you can do. Whenever it's a weekend, we always go out with my boys, have a great time, go for some projects, rap cyphers, battles, hit the club, shake the stress off. When it comes to house parties, I'm the man. When you go around campus asking about house parties, they'll always tell you Fabi, because I've always been a party animal from day one. Case I wanted to go for marriage, definitely black woman. I want to have fun and maximize on life. Ah, white woman. You know how white women be. White women are this kind of women who be like, hey, hey guy, come, let's have some fun. Let's buy some drinks. Black women, well, they say you to fumbe. So the black woman makes you a responsible person in life. White woman wants you to maximize on life. If I was Vice Chancellor of Makerere University right now, I'd revise some of the policies. Like the 60% policy doesn't work for me right now. I'll definitely revise some of the policies. Talking about the strikes, if I'm being oppressed, like the students are right now, I'll definitely strike, no doubts. I mean, who doesn't strike once you're being oppressed? You'll continue being oppressed if you don't do something about it. So you gotta stand up to your feet and do what you have to do. I'm a VIP, VIP at the TIP, TIP, priming really, really like a B.I.G. Running the game all night, trying to get more rich. But always sit to it like chicken, trying to get his feet. Yo, it's your boy Fab E. Don't forget, I'm going to be part of the battle, university battles. The advice I give to the fellow rappers at campus, work hard, pray hard, never give up. That's it.
Yes, we have come to the end of the show. I want to thank everybody who's been tuned in. Campus 101 every Saturday, Urban TV. I'm always here to bring what's happening in your various campuses. And big up to everybody from YMCA 18th graduation ceremony. Yes, your outstanding personality. And just like I told you, I'm still hanging out here at the house party. Jeez, I don't even know what I'm taking, for real. Anyway, see you next weekend for more things coming up on the show. My name is Casmir. Remember, you can check us out. That is on Facebook, Campus101-Official. Instagram people, follow us, Campus 101 Urban TV, because we love campus and we are Campus 101.